Welcome to part 2 of my 3-part Notion Formula series. In part 1, we covered all the new Formula 2.0 changes, along with 6 new and very important formula functions. So if you haven't yet, be sure to go and watch that video before watching this one. In the second part, we'll start playing around with dates, as well as the new ifs function, and I'll show you how to create a weighted grade tracker, a days until deadline formula, as well as a repetition tracker based on your own time intervals. And if you're looking for more advanced formulas, then you need to check out part 3, which will be linked down in the description, along with part 1 and also the student OS dashboard. And now without further ado, let's get started. Let's start off with an easy one. This first formula is for when you need to get the result that is based on 2 different criteria. Let me show you what I mean. Inside of classes, we have our assessments for that specific class with a grade property, a weight property, and a weighted grade property showing how much you got for the year so far. Now, normally we would have just created the roll-up for the classes, select our relation to the assessments database, choose the weighted grade property, and then use the sum function to count everything together, but then we would get the total out of 100 instead of the actual percentage. So what we need to do is create that same roll-up but inside of a formula so that we can make some changes and get the percentage. To do this, we're going to use the new map function, which allows us to use properties from a related database, just like with rollups. I've already covered the map function in depth in part 1 of this formula series, so be sure to check that out if you want to learn more. Let's go ahead and add the new map function and select the assessments database, and then we're going to add a comma and click on current, which will now give us a list of all the related pages. But we don't want to use the page names, we want to use the weighted grade property. So what we're going to do is just add a dot and then select the property we want, which would be the weighted grade property. And now instead of a list of all the page names, we have a list of all our weighted grades. But we want the total, not a list. So we're going to add another new function called sum to the end of the formula, which will add everything together. And then we're also just quickly going to add a round function to get rid of any decimals. Now to turn this number into a percentage, we're just going to put everything inside of brackets and divide it all with 100. Then all that's left is just to edit the property and change the format to percentage, select the progress bar, and change the color to match your theme. Now if we go back to the dashboard, we're able to go into properties and show our yearly grade for each class. The next example is this deadline formula to calculate the total days until your next assessment that will update relatively to the due date. So if it's in the future, it'll display the number of days remaining. If it's tomorrow, it'll show due tomorrow. If it's today, it'll show due today. And if it's in the past, it'll show the number of days past due. For this formula, we're going to introduce a new function called ifs. Previously, this formula had 4 different if statements that you add together with a plus, but now we only need to use 1 ifs function. For this first one, we're saying if the due date property is the same as now, then show the due to date text. But the problem is the now function returns the current date as well as the current time. But we don't want the time because we want them to match. So what we need to do is add a format date function to both of these dates to format them the same so that they're actually able to match. With this done, let's close the first if statement with a comma and then start the next one. This one is going to be the if statement for the days remaining. For this one and all the rest, we're going to use the date between function. This allows us to specify a certain amount of minutes, hours, days, etc. that we want to use as criteria. So in this case, we'll be using the total days between our due date and our current date. So in the date between function, we're going to add our 2 dates and then inside of quotation marks, specify that we want to use the days. Now, because we'll be reusing this line of formula multiple times, we're going to add a let's function, which I covered in depth in part 1, to turn it into a 1-word variable that we can use throughout the formula instead of having to use this long function every single time. So let's go ahead and add our let's function and move the closing bracket to the very end of the formula. The first part of our let's function is the name of our variable. So in this case, I'll just use days between and then add a comma and then add in our function, which is the one we just created, and then another comma to close it off. You can create as many variables as you want, but for this formula, I'll just be using this one. So now that our variable is set, we can replace this whole line with our new days between variable. Okay, so let's continue with the formula. For the second if statement, we're going to say if the days between is more than 0, then show the number of days plus 1, which we put inside of brackets, and then a format function to turn the date value into a text value so that we can then add a plus and our days remaining text inside of quotation marks. Our third if statement, which is a bit simpler, is just if the days between is larger than -1, then show due tomorrow. And our final if statement is if the days between is less than 0, then show the number of days with the format function to turn it into text, and then inside of quotation marks, the days past due text. Now you'll notice in the preview that this number is going into the negatives. It says minus 7 days past due, so to fix this we're just going to add an abs function next to the number of days between, which will give us only the actual number value. And then just make sure to close off this whole if statement by saying if none of these happen, then just show nothing indicated by two quotation marks. Now if we click on done, our formula should be working properly. And just for the sake of curiosity, this is what the Notion formula looked like before this update. And mind you, it was even longer because the property still used the long prop function. So yeah, this new formula update definitely makes things a lot easier and simpler to understand when it comes to creating formulas. The last example is a repetition tracker, which tells you when you need to review your work again. Here you have a deck of flashcards for a specific subject with individual flashcards inside. When you review your work, you would simply go through each question and check the checkbox to reveal the answer to see if you got it right. And then once you've gone through all of the questions, you would check the first rep checkbox and your next repetition date will move to tomorrow. The first revision is after 1 day, the second is after 3 days, then 8, then 16, and then 24 days. And this is all based on the forgetting curve, which, according to science, is the best time intervals for memorizing and reviewing your work. So to create this repetition tracker, we're going to start off with an ifs function, open up the bracket, and then select our fifth rep checkbox. Then we're going to add our date add function. What this does is it adds a certain amount of days, minutes, or hours to your date property. So in this case, it would be our start date, and then we would add 24, and then inside of quotation marks, just specify that it's 24 days. Then we just repeat this for all the checkboxes, but change the time intervals until we get to the last one, where we want to close off the if statement saying that if none of these checkboxes are checked, then just show the start date. Now this last part of styling the dates is optional, because if we do this, then it won't be seen as a date anymore, but a piece of text. So we can't filter or sort our database according to the next repetition property. But if that's fine for you and you prefer to have aesthetics, then let me show you how to style it. First, we need to add a format function to turn the date into a text value so that we can then add our style function. Inside our style function, we want to make it bold with the letter B, turn it into code with the letter C, and change the color by just typing in the color name. Then we just copy and paste this to all the rest and just change the color for each one. And there you go. Now you got the repetition tracker that not only works, but looks aesthetically pleasing as well. The Student OS dashboard used in this video will be linked in the description below, along with part 1 and part 3, so be sure to check those out as well. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in part 3.